within the grounds of the chapel for landscaping to be provided. RPC has amended which provided. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mayor Shuttler, we now say the power of the chair. Cassandra, Ricky, Bradley, Harlow, and the rest of this family.
In fact, more than willing to do the right thing, he
did the right thing. It was not a question of whether you were going to do it or not. We had a general in Okinawa by the name of Ray Ayer. General Ayer, man, was very clear what he wanted out of people and out of people in life. General Ayer, he left 3rd Marine Division to go on to the next assignment. We all gathered for a hailing farewell. And like all hailing farewell, we always expect the person at the meeting to have some well-defined and long speech. Well, General Ayer got up, and he looked at the group of officers and senior enlisted people, and he said, "Ladies and gentlemen, do the right thing. It is not always the easiest, but it is the simplest. That, my friend, is selfish." The next word is the word courage. You'll never meet a more courageous man in this gentle spirit. It's an amazingly courageous individual, both physically, physically. Whatever we did with the Marines, and whatever we did as a staff, he always led the way, whether it was a 5 o'clock morning run, which was very painful for a lot of people, especially Navy people getting up at 5 in the morning, knowing that they'd have to run, or whatever distance that the senior staff wanted to go that particular day or morning. But he always led the way. He led the way once and never complained. And so he set the example for the rest of both the chaplain as well as the RP. The other part, courage, comes when the physical aspect comes when we went through all the training area. Not a particularly nice place to be, but an area where Marine life train in a jungle environment. So we put together a package, an interesting package, a package that all Marines, if they're reporting from Okinawa, particularly those that are reporting coming over the battalion, go through. A package that was filled with all kinds of challenging, physically challenging event for us to do. Unfortunately, when I briefed our division chaplain about how we were going to do this particular exercise, I said that we had to set the example as chaplain and as our reading. And by that I meant that we could not in any way drop out. And Chief Fish led the way. When I say it was a very challenging experience with this exercise, Chief Fish's mother has a video of what we went through. It was more than just doing simple tasks. It was tasks that were physically demanding. And as a result of that, a lot of our RPs had a lot of respect for the man who was their chief. Because they saw in someone who was one just as tired as they were, just as hungry as they were, who was just as dirty as they were, who was just as exhausted as they were, but who never complained. Instead, with a smile on his face that he always had, continued to encourage them to finish what he did. And, unlike other individuals, when we had to set up the camp and when we had to break it down, he didn't say to his subordinates, "You break it down, and I'll watch you," rather than the other way. And he would get dirty. The third thing I'd like to mention to you that thing that we call commitment. We can always say commitment means that you're willing to follow through with everything. But commitment also means to me the commitment to what you think are the highest priorities in life. And the highest priority in this life has always been and will always be family. In Okinawa, you can when other people were taking off as an offer, or taking off to other things as individuals, he spent that time looking his family to visit all kinds of wonderful little places around Okinawa, to include all kinds of places where divers are looking for strange aquatic life. Several years ago, when I was assigned to the Battalion Third Marine, a good friend of mine who was a Battalion Sergeant Major, I asked him a question because he was retiring after 20 years. Sergeant Major, why are you retiring? You've got another, you're a young man. You're only 42 years old. Now, I'm sorry, that said that. He was 38 years old. I said, Sergeant Major, you've got, you can stay 30 years. You can still be a young man. Why are you retiring now? Sergeant Major said to me, said, Chaplain, I have given the Marine Corps everything. When they assigned me to the recruit depot, it was 24-7 for me. Every day, every hour, 2 years, I gave to the Marine Corps and to the recruits that I helped push through. In the process, the Marine Corps rewarded me with the promotion he ate. But in that process, I also lost my family, my children, and me. He says, however, I've been given the second chance. I'm not a veteran. And guess what, Chaplain? I'm not going to give them up for anything. Because when I leave the Marine Corps, they're not going to remember me. The day that I step off this stage, they're not going to remember me. The only thing that I have left, the only thing that means as much to me in my own life, is my family. They'll remember me. That's the commitment that Chief Bishop has made. And part of that commitment that was also demonstrated is the way you took care of people. We always have new sailors coming from Okinawa, new RPs coming from Okinawa. Chief Fish with his family will always be at the airport to welcome all these new families, all frightened to death about the water coming from a strange environment, all wondering what, who is going to meet them and what to expect. They got there, but they saw their chief waiting for them at the airport with his family. And then when he took them personally in his van, not following any van, but his own van, to the particular lodge that he had, the transit family, he had waiting for them items that they would need in order to survive. Food items, milk, all kinds of groceries, everything that they would need in order to make their transition to this foreign country as easy as possible. He paid it out of his own pocket. And then he took them around to make sure that they had everything settled in his life. He could have easily said to someone else, you do it, or that's not my job. But it was something that he wanted to do. Now, in a world where everybody is scrambling around for recognition, recognition found in a variety of ways, either through the awards that you have in the chest, through promotion, position, he had always tried to do the job. In fact, he was the one that told me, don't worry about gets the credit, or wondering whether you're going to get credit for what for one of the meat of the brothers of mine in it before me. Now whether he was doing it because of the scripture or not, I believe he did it because he was part of who he was and he is his father. But he is also a friend of mine. Now, obviously, we're separated by rank. And Chief Fish was the one that always understood the deference that had to be paid based on our service requirements. And yet, at the same time, we're good friends. A friend that I can count on because of one. He would always tell me when I not wanted to hear what he needed to hear. And two, the friend that was there for me. We made a lot of trips together. We visited a lot of foreign places together. We did a lot of wonderful things together. We were in Korea walking around the back streets looking for something to see. We both discovered certain items that we normally don't eat. But we did it together. We had a lot of fun together. We had a lot of nice fun together. But I think all of that can be couched in another thing. And that is this. In the Marine Corps, you learn one thing. At least for chaplains in the Marine Corps. You learn that you don't carry your weapons. So you learn very quickly that the person we need to trust ultimately, absolutely, is this person called your RP. You learn to trust him because you know that there is, if you're in a place of extremity, a place of danger, that your RP that will be there